program is measure ambient temperature using a sensor and SPI ADC IC. So this is the last described program from BTU. So for that we are going to provide four files. We are going to provide four files, that is lcd.c we will give you, lcd.file will give, then SPI.c will give, SPI.v will give. Only thing you have to write is this temperature.adc. So this is the actual program. So two, you have to include lcd.header file plus SPI.h. Okay. So these two plus c file, lcd.c, lcd.h, SPI.c, SPI.v will provide. So only thing you have to need is you have to write this main program. Okay, this program you have to write. That explanation I will give in another video. So I will show you today only how to see the output. So I am giving here the compilation. If you miss any one file, file should be there. lcd.c, lcd.h, then spi.c, spi.h, then temperature ADC. So five files should be there. Only you have to write this file, main file, temperature finding using ADC, that you have to write. These supplementary files we are going to provide. Okay, now if I compile this, so I am going to give this as that X file, I will give it as temper I will give. So click OK. So temper X file will be generated. Now build this. So that is going to generate X file if no errors are there. See here, no errors are coming. So now I am going to open Flash Magic. So in the Flash Magic I am going to browse temper.exe. Yeah, here it is there. So once you click this start programming, I will show in the kit. Again, external no connections are required. Okay, you can see in this one, in the LCD, in the program it is written that temperature, see it is showing temperature 25.7 degree. So where is that? So it is the ADC temperature. There is a sensor, you can see LM35. LM35 is actually the sensor, this one. LM35 is the temperature sensor. So it is actually sensing the temperature, and that is converting temperature into analog value, that will be converted into analog to digital. Okay, and this will be processed and program is written to display what is the room temperature. It is coming, 25.8 degrees centigrade. So now I want to increase the temperature. So what you can do is you rub your finger. So like this, you can rub and you touch this LM35. So I am going to touch this. Now see what happens to the temperature. I am touching this. Now see what happens to the temperature. It is increasing from 26 degree. It is now increased to 31 degree. Still, if you put further any other hot things, so it is going to increase. So now my body temperature is coming around 31.3 degree. If I remove this my finger from the sensor, I am removing my finger, and slowly the temperature will reduce. See, it is reducing continuously. Again, it will come back to room temperature. So that means your sensor is working, your program is also correct, and nothing else extra is required. Okay, only for stepper motor you require additional power supply. For all other programs, this cable is sufficient. And for DAC experiment, generation of square wave and triangular wave, we require CRO. That CRO you have to connect here. DAC experiment, ground is this, output pin is this. CRO has two pins now, so you have to connect red color here, ground here. So that is for DAC experiment, and you have to check the output in CRO. For temperature sensor, this is the temperature sensor. So here you can see the output. See, I am touching once again. So now temperature will increase. If I remove, now I remove, so now it will decrease. So this is about measuring temperature using IC, and we are using SPI. Okay, here the peripheral interface, that one we are using. So theory part, you already know what is SPI in the embedded system. So we are using, making use of that serial peripheral interface.